Hello, everybody. Welcome back to The Binding of Isaac. We will be playing as Isaac again, because, again, that all-powerful D6, really conducive to accomplishing our goals. Please don't take damage right off the bat. Excellent. So on that last run, we had it was a pretty substantial run, actually. I was trying to find Mom's knife, and then eventually I did find it, relieving me of the brimstone curse, and allowing me to get that one item that I needed. Well, I guess I need two items, but get one of the items that I needed in order to get a little bit closer to actually completing the game 100%, or at least completing it as 100% as I can, let's put it that way. Unfortunately, I didn't really give Mom's knife a fair shake last time. I mean, I really liked the item, it was doing an absurd amount of damage. Yeah, let's open this chest. 4 cents! Traded a bomb and a key for 4 cents. It was incredibly powerful. Took out bosses really easily. Unfortunately, I did something like 4 deals with the devil in my last run. So I did not have a lot of health left by the time I got to Satan, and in fact I ended up dying to the Fallen. Not even Satan himself, but it actually did pretty well considering I was living on one heart for quite a long time, but not well enough. Wow, it turns out I really should have saved that bomb, because I could have gotten a fucking treasure trove in there. Maybe we'll get something good from the item room though, and we can access those bombs. That's a goddamn shame if I end up missing out on those. Oh, come on! Ah, the pill! Maybe it's explosive diarrhea! Let's go back here and check it out. Ah, bad gas! That should work as a bomb! We'll shoot all this poop. Because I'm desperate now. Lots of money. Sadly, no bombs. And here, pill bottle? Ooh, a nickel. That's pretty good. Well, you know what? We will use that once, and then maybe re-roll it. Let's see if we get... Okay, maybe explosive diarrhea? Yes! I'm a genius! Okay, so we'll pick up all of those bombs. Excellent! And then we'll go back to the secret room. That really opens things up for us. Oh, well actually the secret room is probably over here. Almost certainly over here, in fact. And contained therein, lots of money! In fact, an unbelievable amount of money. 25 cents on the first floor. Unfortunately, I've already used my key. But, that's alright. Now, I'm actually absolutely going to reroll this, and we'll deal with whatever the boss gives us. So we'll reroll this, pick up 10 more bombs, that's much better actually, and then see who we're fighting here. Monstro, two little monstros, okay. So I think these monstros, oh, I was going to say, I think they lack the ability to do that big jump, but I was clearly talking out of my ass. The reason they are probably called, or probably colored as champion monstros is because it looks like they have less hit points than your average monstro, which is fine by me. Have taken half a heart worth of damage already, half a spirit heart worth of damage, but that's okay. Alright, that was one monstro dead. We're basically fighting a mini version of the one that we know and love so very, very much. Wow, it's hit me twice, I'm amazed. Usually I pretty reliably beat monstro without taking any damage, but do I sound laid back? I am laid back right now. Picked up a speed up. I would rather have almost anything else. But, unfortunately, I don't have the option to trade. But that's okay. We did well on that floor. And we will immediately come here. See what this pill is. Bad trip! Again, I hate when you go into the fucking mob trap room and the item that you get is actually something that damages you. And it's the name of the game, but still. The name of the game sucks dick sometimes. One of the few times I get genuinely frustrated with this game. But on the bright side, we're here on the basement part 2, so these mob trap rooms should be pretty goddamn easy. If we don't get hit here, then no harm, no foul. We get another chest containing a key. Thank you, that's exactly what I was looking for, actually. Although now I'm kind of looking for some more health as well. Especially since I just took a point of damage on the fly, which is embarrassing. Especially considering I'm trying to get the Cave Boy achievement. Well, that champion will die and hopefully give me another key, which will set me up to go to both the item room and the shop on this floor. Well, a penny is good too. Actually, a penny kind of sucks. We will go to the shop first, because then we can potentially buy a key. What did I tell you? We'll get the Steam sale, we'll get the key, and you know what? Why not get the heart too? For only 2 cents. Give me a little bit of peace of mind. Then we'll go into the item room. Mom's bra deserves a reroll. Hourglass, still pretty shitty. We'll recharge our D6. And then have another go at it. And I'm gonna see if I can maybe get an HP upgrade here, or at least pick up some bombs and keys for my gambling addiction. Right, some keys, that's what I was looking for. Should be out of money here relatively quickly. I was kind of hoping to get some more health, though, so I could go to the blood bank. Well, I can't complain. I went from 0 keys to 5 keys. Maybe I can win the hearts here. Three times. Pretty unlikely, I suppose. Come on. Okay, well, at least I want the keys. Give me the keys. Oh, well. We'll blow up slot machine first. Let's get bomb and 2 cents, and let's gamble 2 cents with this guy. Give me your hearts, please. Well, give me anything, really. I've had a good use of my original 10 cents here. Just picking up 5 keys is a pretty solid trade. Well, looks like I will be exploding you, and then maybe getting some help. Well, more bombs and more money. So out we go. On to do a little bit more exploring, and then come back and re-roll whatever that hourglass is. Got a lot of poop in here. So I could use a bomb to go check out what's inside all of that poop. That's a high-risk maneuver, though. We can check out a little bit of it by shooting diagonally at it. It takes a fair amount of time. We'll just check out these two corners. Maybe we'll get lucky. Sadly, nothing. And this has got to be the way to the boss room. One bomb for 5 cents is a fair fucking trade in my eyes. That's basically enough to give me another good upgrade from the shop because I have the Steam sale already. What do we have here? 2 more rooms and my D6 will recharge. Half a heart, that's useful. There's a boss room. Blast assist probably not going to be too much of a problem. I'm happy about my setup now. I'm doing well on bombs and keys. The only thing I would want for is a battery or something to recharge my D6 a little bit faster. D6 is charged. I probably won't be able to use it on both the item room and the shop. Sorry, the item room and the boss. But I will use it on the item room because, you know, it just seems like you get more passive upgrades from, in fact, maybe entirely passive upgrades from beating the boss. And those are more useful to me. So a reroll chocolate milk. Glad I made the decision I did there. That's a pretty good upgrade. Gonna allow us to do a lot more damage, which is actually one of the sore spots in my build right now. I was not able to do a whole bunch of damage. Got a lot of bombs, but there's 3 possible locations for the secret room. So I might just abandon it on this floor. Yeah, sadly we will not get enough to reroll on either the boss room or potentially the devil room as well. But oh well. Oh man, if I can get piercing shots, that would make this build so good. Like a classic Isaac build. Piercing shots and charge shots. See if maybe this is the secret room. Oh, excellent. Save me some time. 3 cents. Not really worth it, but again, money's pretty valuable to me now that I have the Steam sale upgrade. Gonna be fighting Larry Jr. here. I don't expect this is gonna be a significant problem. Except for then, when it just was. Oh, fuck me. Larry Jr. is... I'm getting trapped in this poo prison. Is there any leftover health on this floor? With a build like this, it would be a goddamn shame to lose to Larry Jr. on the basement part 2. Oh, come on. It split into a new head. Look at how much poop there is on the ground. How am I supposed to get it? A foothold in this fight here. Alright, he's nearly dead. I don't think I'm going to lose here, but for a second I got a little scared. Make up your mind. What direction are you going to... There we go. Alright, so we got a lot of money. We're going to get back to full health. Tears Up is a great upgrade. What does Satan want? It's going to have to be pretty goddamn good. Cash equals money equals power for 1 heart. Ugh, tempting, because I really like that item, but I'm going to spend my money. It's a shame I hadn't gotten any HP upgrades, because that would have been a no-brainer. Even with only 1 more heart, I probably would have taken it. Demon Baby's a solid upgrade, too. Maybe not worth 2 hearts, but solid at 1 heart, for sure. I'm getting a lot of stupid damage already, but overall, again, happy with my build. Probably, yeah, you know what, I'll waste a bomb and technically half of a heart to get to that. Got the item room right off the bat, that's actually fantastic, because we know we'll be able to recharge our D6 a few times. Please, something good, it can't be bad trip. Well, retarded pills, whatever. Guardian Angel, it's good. I'm gonna reroll it though. Forget Me Now, probably gonna reroll that too, even though, Forget Me Now is really good for building a character, especially early, because it, you know, it resets the entire floor. But I love having the D6. It makes my life a lot easier. Oh, shit. Okay. There's the boss room. Won't fight the boss right away. We'll make sure we have at least one full D6 charge first, in case we have the opportunity to make a deal with the devil, and the resources to make that feasible. Pretty pro-dodging on my part there. We need to go to one more room in order to make that feasible. But then we might just go re-roll the forget-me-now in the item room. But again, happy with my build right now. Doing some pretty significant damage. It is a tinted rock. I can take out these silkworms in one shot. Let's blow this up. Probably get some spirit hearts. And the increased damage rock. That's fantastic. It's my favorite thing to get from the rock. Let's go to the shop, actually. It should be up here. If there is any higher power in the universe at all, it will be up here. So I don't have to waste too much of my D6 charge that I got built up. Sadly, no. But that was a quick room. Yeah, we'll come down here. Not playing optimally with a D6 right now, but it's okay. Trade a bomb for a key, yeah, that's fine. Give me 7 and 7. Which we now have. And there's the shop, as well as 4 extra cents. I'm gonna be up to 29 cents. Hey, which is pretty substantial. Considering I also have the Steam sale. I can pretty much buy my way out of anything right now. So we will buy the map. In fact, I'm not gonna reroll anything here. We'll just buy the map and get the fuck out. There's the secret room. May have paid for itself already. And here, more bombs and keys probably. A single half heart. Terrible deal for the mob trap room. But let's try to make sure we don't get hit anymore. And, oh, fuck. And then maybe we'll get an item when the room is finished. Probably not, but maybe. There's turrets now? No, these heads. My least favorite. The turrets are fine. There's a set order in which you can take them out easily. Well, that was easy. Sadly, lost a lot of health on that room. Well, I lost the spirit heart. But again, that rock is still hanging out because it still paid for itself. I gotta get a new catchphrase besides paid for itself. Started to sound like my father. 3 cents for a bomb. Market value. I'd rather have the money, though. Because then I can choose what to buy with it, as opposed to just being able to explode things. Did I go to the secret room? I don't think I went to the secret room. I think I unlocked the secret room and then did not even go into it. So let's walk all the goddamn way back here. If I got the map, I might as well fucking use it. And of course, the map is going to make things easier. If we somehow end up being underpowered, we can, choose to just basically bypass straight to the boss. Or at least we'll know when some rooms aren't valuable. We'll just explode the slot machine. Give me a pill. The pill is range up. Okay. That was worth the walk back. Although I would have preferred speed up so that I can make it back faster. And I wonder which boss is a bad enough dude to try to get me out of here. Got increased damage. Charge shots. So one charge shot should pretty much, I don't know, it depends on the boss, but it can take out a good chunk of their life meter. Unless it's Gertie. Oh man, that sucks. I hate little Chad. I'm sorry to say it, but I do. The fact that, you know, I don't like ever being in a position where I'm low on health. So I try to avoid those situations at all costs, even though I'm in one right now. Thankfully I have the lover's item so that I can use that to generate 2 hearts if necessary. Although it probably will not be. It's actually been kind of a tricky fight, because I don't have piercing shots. He's using those laser bullet flies as a pretty effective shield. I think one more shot should take him out. If I could actually hit him, and not his posse. Well, thanks for the spirit hearts. We'll use the lover's card. Pick this up. Get the spirit heart. Get Chad. Go down to the next floor. The reroll is useless right now. Just gives us Chad again. This room, we will go into the secret room, of course. Some expert level dodging on my part there, naturally. The secret room. Give us something good, please. One up. Let's reroll it, just for kicks. Unicorn horn. Immediately wish I hadn't done that. But I'm doing that just in case we can get the magic mushroom upgrade, because obviously that's a cut above. It's in a class all of its own. Don't really want to go to the arcade. I'd rather just go to the shop. So we will continue down this path. Oh man, where did I take that damage? Fly? Then I'm gonna reroll whatever we got from the secret room, because I think those items tend to be better than your average item. Get a magic mushroom, perhaps. I think that might be what I would hold out for at this point. Nothing in this room, so I gotta go to one more before I can. Gotta go to two more before I can charge my D6. And there's the item room and the boss room at the same point. Well, I guess we'll prioritize our rerolls here. The item room has tarot card box. I hate it. Reroll it. Book of Sin. Also terrible. So, we don't want to fight the boss right away, surely. Can I get enough for three more charges? 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2. Probably not. Well, I'm going to reroll whatever's in the item. Again, the boss room tends to be passive upgrades, which are good enough for me. I'll hold on to those. And then I guess I'll use my rerolls on the secret room and the item room. And on the bright side, this will allow me, well, not allow, it'll basically force me to do more exploring. Which should allow me to uncover some more upgrades, potentially. Whoa, it's a shitty room, but diagonal shots combined with my range up should give me an edge. Half heart and a spirit heart to make up for the one I lost. Which is fine by me. I would probably settle for the one up again. I probably should not have rerolled that, to be honest with you. Come back in here. Do I have to use another bomb? What, did the stone, like, spontaneously reform into that pattern? Some never-ending story shit. Reroll unicorn horn. Shovel. We'll come back and reroll the shovel in a minute. Or maybe I'll reroll the item room. I don't know. Remember, I can get one... 1, 2, 3. It depends if all of these rooms have enemies or not. Oh, there's a mob trap room too. Okay, I think I will be able to actually get enough charges to reroll. But then, of course, we have the shop. Maybe I want to reroll in there. You know what? I'll just buy the ladder in here. And not reroll. I'll be contented with my decision. And then we'll open whatever this is. Pick up a bunch of bombs. Fight through the mob trap room. All in the name of getting that D6 recharged. I think this layout has turrets on it, which makes this one of my favorite mob trap room layouts. Especially when I can get those diagonal shots in reliably. Feels good, man. Oh, don't spit the fly on. God, come on. It takes forever. Now, turrets. What I like is that the turrets actually will not spawn over top of you. So even if you're standing. Hey, Spirit Heart. Even if you're standing in the wrong position, you're gonna be okay. Well, we'll get some money out of this. The TNT won't be enough to do it, but one bomb is. Or, of course, I could have just used my ladder and walked over. Oh, I shouldn't have come to this room yet. I'm only going to get one more reroll. Which I did not expect. So I guess we're going to use it. If I was smart, I would probably reroll on the shop, hoping to get the batteries, the spacebar item for sale, and alleviating this problem in the future. But instead, I'm gonna reroll on the secret room, not the item room, and hopefully pick up a one-up or a magic mushroom. Fucking stupid damage, man. Magic mushroom in particular. Oh man, but I can use it on this, I'm firing my laser! Fuck it, we're gonna go back, we'll use it on the secret room. I'm really holding out for the magic mushroom here. What, officer, I was talking about a video game. Come on, magic mushroom. Book of Belial, that's also pretty good, but useless to me. Well, hold on to our D6. Hold on to your butts, guys. Just abandon some pretty good items. In fact, Book of Belial, I'm kind of thinking maybe I should have gone back for that. But no, I won't. We'll try it with what we have. And maybe we'll be okay against Gertie here. It'd be helpful if I had a companion that actually did some damage rather than this guy who's just fucking useless. Drops hearts I have never had to use so far, I think. Wow, nice hit, Gertie. Didn't think you could get me in that position. Fuck, I am sucking hard right now. Don't take that out of context, please. Well, now I can use Chubb's hearts. It's ironic. It's like when you got a spoon and all you need is a knife or something, right? I didn't do very well in English class. That's why I'm an English teacher now. Okay, we got the HP upgrade. That's good. Probably essential, actually, if we're gonna have any modicum of success here. I didn't do very well in English class. Use this modicum in a sentence. Scumbag Northern Lion. Go. Zambi dead. Zambi got revenge. Now we're here for Zambi 3, Revenge of the Sith. And there's the secret room. Let's use our ladder to walk across like a cool kid. And our ladder to walk back. Hey! I'm not gonna reroll this. Tons of cash! Cold, hard, throbbing, erect cash. Why did I just stand there and take that bullet on the chin? Embarrassing level of ineptitude right now. But hey, there's the item room, and that's good, because we're in like the worst possible layout for a room that I can imagine right now. Really gotta sever some heads. Not that that kills the beast, but still. Hey, that room worked out pretty well, actually. Drop a half-heart chub. Make my life a little bit easier. Teleport. Hideous. Homing shots. Not hideous. Not that useful anymore, because I actually know how to aim in this game. But better than nothing. Dealing with guts. Nice homing shot there. Well, thanks for the half hearts. We could go to the mob trap room. Well, I could reroll the mob trap room. But considering my problem lately has been I haven't had enough opportunity to reroll. Or haven't had enough charge to reroll. I've had too many opportunities to reroll. Maybe that's not going to be necessary. Homing shots might be a good match for my leapers here. If I could... Yeah, there we go. Not so bad. Get the key. Okay. Kind of unfair setup you had going right there at the beginning, guys. But that worked out really well. There's the shop. Sorry, LJ. I don't think this one's going to work out too well for you. Brimstone would have taken him out in one shot. But I digress. One more. Yep. Not bad at all. Key and a half heart. Probably greed. Just, you can feel greed coming sometimes. He'll give us a lot of money, which is unfortunately largely useless. But what this does mean is that I have an opportunity to go back to the mob trap room, reroll whatever was on that pedestal, because now all I have to worry about is the boss room, and I can get two more charges before the boss room. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, depending on how many rooms have enemies in them and how many don't. Reroll this. Skeleton key. Why not? That's enough of an incentive for me. Pretty much just gave me 94 keys. Which is nice. Nothing to sneeze at. I can open a lot of chests. Oh, that homing shot actually did pretty fantastically. Homing shots plus range. Pretty nice mixture. And again, I like this build. It's a classic Isaac build. I don't think we have any items that were added in the Halloween update. Except little Chad? Was he? I think he might have been in the game before. Well, thanks for the key. All 95 of them. Now we'll make our way to the boss. Potentially pick up some more items along the way. Maybe. Probably not, but maybe. This room should be, by all accounts, pretty easy, but I don't like it. Got a scent out of it, though. So it's something. Again, any room with nubs, things to shoot at you, I don't like unless I have adequate defense. But we can use our range advantage to our advantage here. Blow up this rock. Oh man, it would be awesome to get bombs or key now. Well, got 3 cents out of that, but I did waste a bomb. Focus. One zombie at a time. That's gonna be my tagline when I run for president in the zombie apocalypse. One zombie at a time. I'm gonna do that weird accent too. Tell people I'm from North Dakota. Spoilers, nobody knows anybody from North Dakota. It's foolproof. Alright, we'll use our ladder and one of our 99 keys. Hey, spirit heart and a bomb. That's a perfect trade for me. And we got another room full of zombies, but we'll definitely use a bomb here to get to 3 bombs. Now, if I don't bother them, they shouldn't bother me, right? That's how they work. Oh, no, I'm thinking about bears. Also a scary... Probably the scariest thing on Earth other than zombies. That was actually pretty easy. What's our tarot card? The Fool takes us back to the spawn room. Not likely to be too bloody useful here. Where do I want to go here? It's like we got a puzzle. Well, I'll use one bomb to get to that bomb. Just in case there's something I'm missing. I'll use one bomb here. And one bomb here. So two bombs to get to two bombs. I think I'm still coming out ahead. And then this should be enough to get me to the other bomb. No, I'm gonna have to waste one more. Alright, well, I think I came out even there. Maybe I got a little bit of a... I think I might have gotten one or two bombs out of it. And we've explored absolutely everything. Hey, and another chest. Whoa, whoa! Be cool! I thought you said... I just told you to be cool. You're being the opposite of cool. You're being super hot right now. Not in a good way. Mila Kunis. What's our... retarded pills. This will hold on to the Fool. I'm not sure how that would ever come in handy, but maybe. Yeah, we're fighting Loki. I can't remember. I question this, whether Loki ever drops anything but Loki's horns. I think it does. Fucking spikes blocking my shots. That's okay. Loki's very nearly dead. Yep, and now we got one bomb fly to deal with. We got an HP up. I don't really want to reroll it. I'm going to reroll it. And we got an HP up. That's good, I didn't want to reroll it anyway. That was the best of both worlds. Justin Bieber. Let's go up here. I was kind of hoping that would be the item room or the shop right off the bat. Homing shots, you're not quite doing what I want you to do here. Just turn off the homing for a second. I can handle this room by myself. Another heart, I'll make good use of that at some point, hopefully. Oh god, champion zombies! And the fetuses that love them! Get a shot in on this fucking zombie apocalypse here. That's the problem. Zombie apocalypse would be much better. So much bacon. Canadian bacon. Oh. Well, a homing shot helped me out there. And there. Got a bomb. Got some money. Got some useless hearts. Man, I could buy a lot of shit from the shop. It's gonna be like Black Friday. It's actually Monday. None of that is necessary. Nubs and the item room. Which we can reroll. And we will reroll. Mom's knife! Cool! Stab, stab, stab. I was hoping we'd get this. Whoa. Cool dress up, too. So it's the same. We're gonna be able to charge it. Because we have chocolate milk. So I've had Mom's knife entirely with charge items so far. The Empress. Now that's a good one. That gives us the curse for a room. So this should be cool. I'm gonna try out the knife again. Didn't get much of a chance to see it work last time. Looks like my range up has been pretty much made useless. But that's okay, because this has unbelievable power! And that's really what I'm looking for right now. Good reroll. Probably the best reroll I've had so far. Now we'll do some more exploring, yet again. Single heart. Don't need that just yet. Oh lord, I apologize for that. Viewer discretion is advised. Come on. Yeah, I'd be scared too. You should just stay there. I wonder if you have to get really close to them if you don't have charge shots. Probably. Secret room contains greed? Oh, the noose! That allows us to fly! That's fantastic. I don't need that ladder anymore. And also, I'm probably the scariest being you will ever see in your entire life. Also, I think that gives me a little bit of increased speed, which is fantastic for me. You should not be able to hurt me! Knife back. Not too scared about guts in this position. Hey, there's the shop. And contained therein, we have the magnet, which I don't need because I can get to anything. So let's reroll it. And we got the compass. Why can I already see everything on this floor? Because of the noose, right? Maybe I just wasted my time buying the compass. Wasted my money, rather. But this is the last shop. It's the tarot card, Wheel of Fortune. I'm just going to explode it, just because I don't want to waste time with it. Got a bomb and 2 cents out of it. I'd say that was worth 3 cents. So in order to charge up our D6, we'll explore every remaining room. And there's the blood bank. I could probably play that like 15 times, given how much health has surrounded me in these other rooms. Let's play it. Let's see how much we can play it before things get nasty. This is 6 hearts. 7 hearts. At least 7 there we go. Don't even have to worry about it anymore. Not even gonna do the math. Got another HP up. Man, this is the most badass build I've ever had. Like a fucking messiah just flying through these levels. One hit wasn't enough. I find that hard to believe, to be honest with you. I'm liking this Isaac style where you just... This is like a yes man gameplay where you're like, reroll? Okay, I'll take it, whatever. Feels good, man. Got a boss room, of course. Oh, okay. I think we're gonna be alright versus Fistula. Whoa. Damage? What the fuck is damage? I like that mom's knife does damage on the back. It's like you're getting smashed in the back of the head with the handle or something. And we'll check out this last room here. Oh, I forgot we were fighting mom. You're gonna die in like 2 seconds, bitch. Like quite literally, this is gonna be one of the quickest mom fights we've ever had. Let's not worry too much about the enemies here. Let's focus on mom's leg. Oh, more dumb damage. But oh well. Instead of firing really quick, or firing a charge shot at mom, I should probably just try to get off a bunch of little ones. Okay, this might, oh, that might have done it right there if I'd actually hit. I can't believe I actually lost health in this fight. That was easy. HP up, let's reroll it just for shits and giggles. Range up, well, that could be useful. Does my default go any further now? How about my fully charged one? Maybe? Hard to tell. So now we'll just make a beeline for the boss room, essentially. That was quick. This is also gonna be pretty goddamn quick. Really makes circle strafing a little bit more effective. Man, people hated Brimstone. I can't imagine they're enjoying Mom's knife. But it feels good. It actually takes a little bit more skill than Brimstone. Works really well in conjunction with the noose. This monster is gonna die in like 2 shots. Maybe 3. Okay, 3. These are real monsters too, not like the champion monsters that have diminished HP. That was easy as hell. Who's our boss fight against? The Fallen. Alright, well, I'm fast. Which gives me seriously, one of the things that normally fucks you up against the Fallen is that he's normally so much faster than you are. Oh, there's one dead. Whoa! That was quick. There's no avoiding that one, unfortunately. That was easy as hell. What is this? Little Chad or Sister Maggie? I don't want Sister Maggie. Fuck that. Alright, I'll take Sister Maggie then. I suppose I could reroll it a couple times. But, oh, that's a long trip to the boss room. Whatever. Half heart, I guess that is necessary for now. Somehow I ended up taking some damage on that last floor. Fly bomb, not interested. Judgment, what's up, buddy? I'll pay you some of my time here. Any requests? Tarot card the world. Oh, that's pretty good, but the Empress is better for me right now. Not sure if Mom's knife has a damage set or a damage cap. Lard, oh, that's sick. 2 more hearts for decreased speed, but I'm already flying, so I'm going pretty fast. I shouldn't even fuck around with this room, to be honest with you. Especially since I just took dumb damage, but hey, we got a spirit heart and a half heart out of it. Could go to that room, or the arcade, but don't really want it. It's all about my enjoyment now, sorry guys. Oh, watch the fuck out. Yeah. Knife's gonna give it to you. What are you gonna do? If I could actually get it to hit you. It's easy as hell. Walked right into that. Champion. 2 hits? We'll see. If I could actually hit him. Well, he will take 2 hits. Maybe more, actually. Nope, of course not. Bad trip. Probably gonna get rid of that pill. For range up, why not? Is this going to give us any discernible upgrade? Hard to tell. These guys go down in 1 hit. If I could actually hit them. Bomb and a half heart. Amazingly, I'm taking damage. Let's fight Mom's heart. Again, it does so much damage to Mom's heart right away. It's really substantial amount of damage. down to like 60% already. Maybe a little bit more, 75. Again, you can just hammer away at her really quick. Maybe that's the strategy that I'm missing here. I've always had charge items with Mom's knife, so maybe I should just go for it as quickly as possible. But the range on it when you don't charge it is really small. Well, Mom's heart is nearly dead. Very, very nearly dead, in fact. Well, that wasn't so bad at all. Let's pick that up and then go down to the next floor, and hopefully we'll be able to get to the boss room quickly. No such luck. That's, whatever, it's just fistula. Shit! I'm sorry I said anything! Can we just hold the knife in front of us and do damage? Like, can we walk into things? Maybe that's how the item's supposed to work. Oh, come on. Silkworm, you really think you got a chance? Could use some hearts, though, strangely enough. Really shitty luck on my part there. Oh, Fly's dead. Headless Horseman almost caught me there. Yes. Speed up, reroll. Magic Mushroom, damage up. Much better. Whoa, this is a fast version of Monstro too, man. Shit. Took some damage. Killed it quickly. Got a half heart back, so net loss of a half heart on that room. Shit, the Fallen? Still getting fucked on my Satan runs here. Well, Fallen wasn't so bad. Got another half heart out of it. Come on, give me something good. Lasered eyes! That's not good. In fact, that's pretty goddamn bad. What do I have? Tower card? That sucks. I'm gonna do some more exploring before we fight Satan. And hope that I pick up some hearts. This is a bad room for me. I made a poor decision. Let's go check out this room up here. I might not even make it to Satan. Sadly. Well, okay, we should be able to beat this guy. Get a key out of it. That's exactly what I needed. I didn't even check out the secret room. Let's go in there so that greed has a chance to end our video the way it should be. So we'll plant a bomb here. Run backwards. Hearts, please. Just a ton of hearts. Alright, I'll put out my fire with this knife. Go examine down here and hopefully not get... Oh, judgment! Save my life! Oh, okay, that's a start. You just doubled my chances. But an HP up would be good too. More hearts. Okay, that's fantastic. He always gives you what you need, man. I don't really need that, but it's the thought that counts. HP up, okay. So we're up to 4 hearts now. Now I'm wondering if I should keep going or if I should risk it and go fight Satan right away. The whole scheme of things, Loki should be a pretty easy fight. Should be being the operative word there. Okay, that went well. I didn't get anything for it, but it went pretty well. Okay, one of these guys, again, should be easy. Maybe Chubb will drop a half run. Chad will drop a half run. There we go. Starting to make progress. Oh, God! Sloth. Again, this should be a pretty easy fight, too. But we gotta hit him in order to actually do damage to him. Or hit one of them. There we go. Lover's card, please. Justice. Well, Justice is a good card, too. Get a half heart. A few items. Building up a supply here. Now, I should probably... Fuck. Should probably start thinking about fighting Satan. Because I'm taking an extraordinary amount of damage, and I was very briefly looking like I was in a position to succeed, and now I'm once again in a position where I'm likely to fail with only one heart left. Which means we gotta do some more exploring. And we found a chest! Contained a half heart? That's not a lot. Oh man, these rooms are dick holes. Got another heart out of it. Remember when we had 5 hearts? 2 rooms ago? That was awesome. Tammy's head. Reroll it for the razor blade. Everything about that sucks. Tammy's head, though, wouldn't have been worth it to us, probably. I mean, that's one of the items we need to get the parasite item, but I need to find another dead thing before I can make use of that. I'm really just like a full health pill would save my life now. Nothing? Maybe these guys will drop the pony. Highly unlikely. But I suppose within the realm of possibility. Alright, with just the horse, we should be okay. That was close. As was that. Too fucking close, in fact. Okay, we're gonna re-roll Tammy's head one more time before the fight. If we get to the Satan fight, which we don't! Fuck! Well, that was the best I could do. Mom's knife's a good item, but... Man, I'm having some trouble in my runs with it. Need a little bit more health, he says, as, like, 10 health containers are on the screen. Anyway, as always, thank you guys for watching. Really gotta get that parasite item sometime, but yeah, I'll catch you next time.